It feels like many days since I've celebrated Mass with you during the weekday. I was on retreat last week, and it was a very good retreat. I was grateful to Anne to have a communion service the day that we didn't have a priest. So thank you for your patience, and Anne, thank you for your leadership. When someone called Julie, I said, Julie, I'm already at a funeral at St. Thomas Aquinas, so by the time I'd get back, you would be long gone. So God provides well. The retreat went very well. 45 of the 200 priests we have are on retreat. We have three other retreats, so we can't all go on retreat at the same time, nor is the retreat center at San Pedro big enough to accommodate us. But Bishop Harrington, a retired bishop from Winona, Minnesota, was our retreat director, and he was marvelous, just marvelous. But even if, you know, say the retreat director wasn't that good, it's a good time to spend in prayer. It's very edifying, too, and I think you would find it quite touching to see the priest going to confession, seeing the priest in the Adoration Chapel, seeing the priest spending time before Mass or before morning or evening prayer in the chapel praying. It's just a good thing to see. It's good for my heart, good for me to see it. It just kind of reminds me. And to see this year so many priests, usually on the last day, Friday morning, it's like the remnant of Israel, because everybody's gone back to their parishes. They have busyness again to get back to. And it was nice to see so many remaining to the very, very last hour. It's a good thing. We had a marvelous penance service. Bishop Harrington picked up our review of conscience from the Catholic bishop's site. Very thorough. It was like 4 pages. And wow, was that a very good review of conscience. I kept that for myself, which I will share with you sometime. Sometimes we have busyness we have to tend to, unfortunately. I had to go over to Orlando to mediate between Bishop Noonan and a priest. You know, on rare occasion, priests and bishops don't always see eye to eye. We heard Paul's letter today, and that's always the letter that always seems, even for myself, a bit, where's Paul going with this? About wives being subordinate to their husbands. But it's a great precursor to Christ and ourselves, the church, how the church is subordinate to Christ, at least our church is. In other words, it's not about me. It's not about Pope Benedict. It's not about you. A lot of people say this is our church. And I don't mean the building or the parish so much, but people say this is our church. It's Christ's church. It always has, always will be. When people don't like that, they just go out and start their own church. And they just do as they see fit. We are so blessed as Roman Catholics, so blessed that we have the magisterium, the teaching body of the church. Because I'm not a very smart person. I know everybody else is, but I'm not. And I need people to guide me, lead me. I need people to guide me through the storm and through the good weather. You know, and the church is not something that just goes like this. Woo, we're going to go this way because everybody's going this way. We're going to go this way because everybody's like this. We're just going to go with the times. We're just going to do whatever the people want. In a sense, we want that. And in reality, it's the worst thing for us. Yeah, children want to do whatever they want. And we see what happens to children, grown children, when they've gotten whatever they wanted. When children lead the household, we see where that goes, don't we? Chaos. So we are part of a great church that is, in fact, subordinate to Christ. And when we're not subordinate to Christ, we do our own thing. Oftentimes we do the easy thing. Or we do what others with the loudest voice will call us to. What a blessing it is to be a Roman Catholic. You know? There's easier, much easier religions to be a part of, and far more entertaining. Oh my goodness, we have great music here. Thank you, Brad. But not all Catholic churches have great music. A lot of things we're sort of shy on, but the only thing we're not lacking is teaching. Oh, so we are subordinate to Christ. And Christ loves us like he loves his own body. He loves us so much. He will always provide for us and protect us. And all he asks of us is to be subordinate to him, to his will, to his teaching. But then there's that personal free will that keeps setting in. Oh, I want to do my own thing. I want to do my own thing. Don't tell me what to do. And we were a great church for that. It was almost like poor Pope Paul VI, this wonderful, saintly man, and the whole church of God rise up and say, all right, we're smart now. We are enlightened. We are coming into the new age, and, well, you just sit there and look sharp, because we know it all. And what happened to our church, our holy church? Only a remnant of the faithful. You know, so much misguidance. And not from the laity necessarily. Not from the priests, but the bishops themselves. One wonders. It's okay to question, I think. I really do. I think that's good for scholarship. But without obedience, because without obedience, there's no love. It's not our church. It's not my church. By the way, that makes it a little easier on me, too. I can sleep better at night when there's chaos among the body of Christ. I'm like, hey, it's not my church. It's your problem. I'm only a servant. You know, you stay up late at night. You worry. But really, we are so blessed. We're on a ship. It's not a fancy cruise ship. It's not real fancy. It's crowded, a lot of smelly people, because we're sinful, but we're on the right ship. We are. And if you ever wonder that, just watch again Mutiny on the Bounty. For me, an incredible image of the Roman Catholic Church. Incredible image. Has nothing to do with the church, but it's a great paradigm to think about. Watch the one with Marlon Brando. That seems to be, that captures it the best. Captain Bligh, oh my gosh, rules, 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 all these rules. And of course, Marlon Brando, Fletcher Christian, nice guy, let's be nice. Be nice, be patient, be thoughtful. They mutinied, right? Fortunately, they threw Captain Bligh and the loyal ones onto this little ship, little dinghy, tiny little thing. And there they're on the big boat. They have all the water they need. They have the boat. Great big boat. They're great. And the little dinghy with this mean-spirited guy, you think this is going to be a fiasco. And you're almost going to say, you all need to go down. They have no food, very little water. And what happens? There's order in that little boat. In that little boat, there is fairness. There's order. There's sort of a subservience or sort of following orders. And sure enough, they catch a bird, a tiny little bird. And so I guess it was the cook way at the front. He has to cut it up. Well, you can't cut it up equally. It's impossible. So Captain Bligh in the back says, the next piece goes to so-and-so. The next piece will go to so-and-so. The next piece, the fairest you could do. And that way, no one was treated unfairly. They make their way into port, and of course, they're protected. The boat, the ship, the big ship, with the water, the food, all they need. After they threw Captain Bligh off the ship, then these sailors say to Fletcher Christian, the nice man, don't tell us what to do. You're not going to tell us what. Who are you? Who are you? Complete chaos on the ship. Complete chaos, mutiny. If we threw him off the boat, we can throw you off the boat too. One after another after another. It is a marvelous example of our church and how there is order. We have the Holy Father. We have the magisterium. And we trust that along with ourselves in concert, they lead and guide us closer to Christ. I have no fear at all. I have no anxiety whatsoever. I'm on the right ship with the right guidance, and I know what Christ expects of me. When I have any doubt, I can look to the church, and I know what I have to do. There's no worry. I know how to vote. I know what I need to do. I know what God expects of me. I have no fear. Let us stand and pray. Amen.